So you ever just sit in bed and you're thinking like, why can't I just have what I want? Like, why is life like, why do I have to work so hard to get the things I want? You know, some people obviously have it easier than others. Some people it's a little bit harder to get what they want. Like, why couldn't I have just been born with the things that I wanted, or at least have a little bit more of the things I wanted? Or even just, why are the things that I want so hard to get, right? Like, why do I have to work so hard just to get whatever this thing is that I want? What I realized is part of that is you just don't want what you have necessarily, or you're not thinking about it. Obviously, you don't want to lose what you have, but you're just not thinking about wanting what you have. So, like, you've ever wanted something like a video game or like a shirt or, you know, something, just some object of some sort, for example, or even not an object. And then you get that thing, and then eventually, you know, maybe the first week, first month, first couple months, maybe even, you're still really hyped. You're still really excited that you have this thing. You bought this thing, you saved up some money or whatever it is, and you finally got this thing. And then in a week, or like I said, a couple months, you're kind of, it's just part of your thing, right? You get new shoes and you're like, yo, my new shoes are like super nice. I love my new shoes, right? And then after a few months, they're just kind of your regular shoes. You obviously still like them and they're still cool, but the novelty of them have kind of worn off, and they're just kind of regular shoes. And then eventually, you start looking for new shoes again. It's the same thing when I buy my model kits, my Gundams, and stuff like that, right? Like, you get really excited to get that new kit. You look at all the pictures and stuff like that, and you want this thing. You're so excited to get this new model kit. It looks so cool. And then you finally get it, and then you may or may not build it. But then, you know, oftentimes you don't build it. It just sits in your backlog, and then you start looking at new model kits, and then you want to get another model kit, and then that old one is just sitting there in your backlog, and you either never really end up building it, or eventually you build it, but it's a little bit of a, you got to force yourself a little bit. The difference is not in how much effort it is. It's not really like, oh, I wish the things that I wanted took less effort or were easier, or I wish I had the motivation to get those things and whatever. There's that. There's obviously, that's part of it. You need to be motivated and all that stuff to get the things you want. But also there is something to be said about wanting the things that you already have, or being satisfied or happy that you have what you have. Because the difference is in your own perspective. It's not in those things. It's not in the effort or the actual things themselves. The difference is in your own perspective of what, you know, what happened when you got that thing that you wanted. You wanted this thing for so long, you finally got it, and then what happened to your brain? You just turned it off and you're like, you know what, that's, you know, it's great. And then you just kind of ignore it and you look for the newest thing, right? Like, it just, you don't want it. When you have it, you don't want it as nearly as much as when you didn't have it. And so that's a perspective thing. I think that's something that we have control over with our own minds and brains, is that, you know, you got to realize that you do have a lot of things. Like, so if the example is, you know, let's say you're in the desert for however long and you haven't had a sip of water, all you would want at that point is just a sip of water. You would just like, just someone please give me a bottle of water or something like that, right? But as of right now, obviously I'm in a situation where I have fresh water. You know, I live in Vancouver, BC. We have the freshest water. At any point in time, I can get myself a bottle of water whenever I want to. It's easily available. And so I'm not always thinking about, you know, like, oh, I just really wish I wanted a bottle of water. It's like, no, I mean, I can, if I want one, I can just go grab one, right? My need for it, my want for it, my craving for that bottle of water is really not that big of a deal. But if I was in, like I said, a desert and I haven't had a sip of water for like a week or 2 weeks, like, I would be dying for a bottle of water. I would be dreaming about that bottle of water, right? So again, that is situational, but also perspective wise, right? Like, in, you know, if you live in the West here, if you live in the first world, obviously a lot of the things that you want are somewhat available, depending on, you know, how much effort or how much money it takes. But that perspective of what you need to do to get there actually, like, less important. It's more about, do you want that thing because you just want that thing? Or is this like just the next thing, right? And so you think about like the neuroscience behind it. There's dopamine, right? Which is the thing that always makes you want to go and move, generally speaking, right? Like, dopamine is the neurochemical that's like external. We have to go get that thing. I want to go out and do this. Go, you know, ambition, very ambitious. Go do this, go do that, go do this, go do that. You're always moving. You're trying to achieve things, trying to get things all the time. Whereas serotonin is meant to be the opposite. It's to make you be more satisfied with what you have right here, right? Dopamine is go out and get stuff. Serotonin is be happy with what you have, right? So I think there's a lot of power in that, and changing your perspectives of being really grateful for what you have, also, right? That way you're not lying in bed crying or being sad about the things that you don't have. Like, why can't I have those things? You know, like, why can't it be easier to get the things that I want? Whereas, you know, another perspective is you just look at other people, and I'm sure there are a lot of people out there that would just die to have what you have, right? Like, a lot of people would die to have the situation that I have, where I have just like a nice place to live. I can eat whatever I want. I have all the things readily available for just a nice, comfortable life, right? I have a lot of friends. I have this and that. Like, a lot of people would be really happy to have what I have. They're fighting to get what I have, right? Like, a lot of people are fighting, working and all this stuff just to get what I have, right? And so I'm really grateful for that, that a lot of it, you know, I worked for some of it. A lot of it, I just, by situation I had, whatever, I have it, right? But I don't focus on those things enough, I think, right? I focus too much on what I don't have, right? And so it is, I think it brings a lot of power to change that perspective and focus on what you do have. Okay, so I think a lot of people are there, right? Like, a lot of people have those moments where they're just like, why can't I just get that thing, right? Like, why is it so hard to get that thing that I want? And really, you forget that a lot of what you have already, people are craving and dying for the things that you already have, right? So it's not to say that you shouldn't still work for those things, but you have to also realize how much you do have, right? A lot of people don't have what you have, and you need to be thankful for that, I think. And I think that will bring you more energy and more happiness, and it'll just make life a lot better when you use that perspective. I hope that helps, you know, for people that are feeling that type of feeling. It's something that I struggle with sometimes too, and I think a super useful concept to think about. And so I think if you guys want to hear more stuff like this, please let me know. Ask me a question or whatever, and I'll cover that stuff. You can tell me what kind of content you want to see from me, and I will do my best to produce that type of content. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll catch you guys in the next video.